need to level up to get some antler rattler thingamabobbers. But maybe we'll loop our way over there. Right now I'm gonna see if I can go get myself mauled by some bison. Because that's fun. Not to say the ambient effect noise is actually way better than the Hunter Classic. It actually has like a direction. It's like directional ambient noise instead of just, it's just there ambient noise. I've been mainly been hunting in the Hirschfelden, have not checked out any of the other available reserves so far. Which I'm cool with. Again, the game looks pretty good. There's a lot of post. Fuck. Alright, let's go get ourselves hurt by a boar. I'm probably gonna have to run fast travel back to base after I run through all my bullets here. I think it got its back right leg. You have to be careful. Stalking these suckers is a health hazard. For all I know, I might be turning around to come at me through these pines. I'm still on the basic starter gun here. Caliber's not that hot. So, must be wary of that. Looks like there is a herd. At least a hold on. Flesh wound, son of a gun. See, I should have got more ammo and changed my bullet type. This is gonna be dangerous. Oh shit. Bet you it's pissed off right now. Put the dodge around the trees and hope for the best, guys. On this episode of When Animals Attack, Wash's Foolish Hunter gets trampled by a European bison. Sheesh, you're loud. Hold on, I'm coming for you, I'm coming for you. There it is. Right up the arsehole. Oh, it's pissed. Here it comes. Oh crap. Reload. Yes, how the ammo is. It's yelling at me right now. Come at me, bro. Well, actually don't. Oof. Oh shit. Is it running away? It's running away. Did it just shit itself as it ran away? Alright, we got some major bleeding now. Blood trail. Bleed rate low. Never mind. Looked like major bleeding. I should get some XP for freaking tracking this stuff. Is it dead? Oh my gosh, that was the easiest one yet. Alright, let's see how many bullets we wasted on him. Ooh, he's a biggin'. Let me take a pick. You gotta be careful, because these guys will defend each other. Thankfully, this bugger was alone. I'm hella paranoid after I ran into like a herd of 20 bison this one time. It was a nightmare. Alright, I need a better angle here. There we go. The lighting's kind of shit, but I'll take it. Confirm trophy. Flesh wound, flesh wound. Flesh right lung, flesh liver, flesh right fibula. Oh, flesh right front fibula. Oh, uh-oh. Family's coming to figure out what happened to him. That's, I think I got enough bullets for one more. Oh man, this is such a bad idea. Such a bad idea. Oh! That was a freaking follow deer. It's a big antlers on that thing. Or maybe not, hold on. Oh yeah, that's pretty good. What the fuck was that? Oh, rabbit. That threw off my shot! There's something else over here. I am concerned about this environment. Something's stalking me, and it is not Bigfoot. What the fuck? Are you guys seeing this? What in the world is going on? That must be a bug. Found a rest zone for bison. I doubt I hit that dang deer. It was such a snapshot. What the frick? Well, found it! Wow. It's the first time I've seen a glitch like this. Stuck on a rock. Oh my gosh, tanking. Wow. They weren't lying when they said that the freaking AI was derp. Testines, pelvis, stomach, liver. That wasn't the way I wanted to hunt that, but we'll take it. It's giving us points. 116 XP, 857 cash. Alright, it's starting to get really dark. We are most definitely going to need to fast travel back to base and change the time, which costs cash, in-game cash, to do, which kind of sucks. But we'll do it. So let's pull up the map. I've been hunting the heck out of this particular area. Going to go. I think I'm going to go back this way and work my way to the west to see what we run into. It's not charging for fast traveling. What's up, Nero 77? Really need to get an overlay so I can see what the heck is going on in the chat. Alright. Now we're going to go ahead and hop over here. Change the time. Let's do 6:49. There we go. Alright. So gauge buckshot. I'm good. Okay. I think I have almost enough money to buy. Yeah, I can buy a new rifle. But that's accuracy is high, recoil low, reload, and speed. Is it headshot? I didn't know I could headshot. Less accuracy on this one. Hip shot is higher, not lower. But the caliber is also smaller. So, no. I need to probably save it for a Huntsman. There's a 7mm Regent Magnum. That's kind of cool, but I want a larger caliber bullet. That lever action looks pretty legit, though. Recoil is pretty high, hip shot's fine. I might pick up a lever action. But as you can see, I'm only at 14,000 on the upper left. And volume is a bit off. So let me see what I can do. I can only lower game volume. As for the mic volume, this thing does not quite pick up my voice as well as I would like it to. But let me do some tweaks right here, real quick here before we continue on. I might be able to get this to a decent level of volume. Let's see here. Test, test. Yeah, it's really low. Let's go to properties. Mic levels is up. That's better. Might get more background. You probably hear my CPU raring in the background, but that's as high as I can get this mic. Alright, back to it here. I can get a bow if I really want to get punched in the face by a bison. That's the way to go. But then I would have to get arrows. I'm gonna save up for the rifles. Oh, I need to buy more bullets. Derp. Alright, so first let's get our standard soft point bullets. They're free, so I'll buy a ton of them. Soft points have 30 penetration, 4 expansion. Weapon class 2, I hear that, Fox, and I hate your guts. And this one here, it gives expansion, which I believe is more damage out upon penetration, but the penetration is lower, which means I gotta get closer, I believe. Alright, so we have a fox over here. Let's go see what the fox says after I put a bullet into it. But the Zen chips from AMD have come out, and I've been considering doing a build for that. Oh, there you are, you little bastard. This is going to be one hell of a long shot here. Oh, no, you didn't. There's no way that thing got away. I think it may have fell over next to the boulder. I hope it did, because that should have been a good hit. The fox's hitboxes, as I've noticed, seem to be a bit off. And by a bit off, I mean a lot off. It's hard to tell if this bullet dropped, because you can't really see particle effects of the bullet hitting anywhere hitting the ground. At least I hadn't shot the ground or noticed it on my misses. Yeah, that is so weird. That's why I don't like hunting these foxes. Hey, what the frick? It's a resting area. And I am not hunting this fox. It's too much of a hassle. But it's kind of going the way I'm going, so I guess I'll follow along. I will follow along anyways, but I have no real intent on taking this fox. Okay, so what's kind of cool is you can see the depression in the grass here of where the fox has passed through, which is pretty cool. And if they gave me bonus XP for tracking animals without these little helping highlights, I would be all over that. But they don't, so I'm not gonna bother. Oh wow, it is a downpour. On the bright side, it seems to affect my audio presence a lot, so that's good. Mating call of a followed deer. And it's male. Not seeing anything. So we shall move on. Okay, that's some blueberry coffee, but it tastes more like black licorice. That's sweet black licorice, and I hate black licorice. Man, it is pouring. Okay, well, if I'm not careful, I will fall and hurt myself. Oop, down we go. Down we go. Oh, shimmy Christmas. I'm doing pretty good. Well, I'm catching up to this fox. Sometimes you don't really need to follow the trail. I feel like they did do a better job of the paths these animals take outside of that one moment where we found a deer glitched out on a rock. But I mean, like, their general pathfinding seems to be a little bit more natural. Which is nice, like you can kind of see the intent in the direction they want to go and kind of preempt them. So I like that. So when I lose their trail, I kind of understand where they're trying to head, so I just keep going in a particular direction. I end up oh dear, made a call. Okay, I didn't even hear that. But I have noticed that the graphics, the closer you get to something, the worse it looks. But in the same breath, if they're too far away, it also looks bad. There's like this middle area where everything looks really good. And that middle area is about 150 meters from you. If you get the proper lighting on, it kind of makes everything look alright. Oh, that was an objective. Give me XP. No? Okay. Let me check this track again. Alright, it's at a trot, so this fox is still wary of my presence. Oh, my guy's being loud as heck. Generally, most of my successful hunts of the fox have been me pegging them at extreme ranges, trying to get within 30 meters of a fox. In and of itself is a pain in the arse. See, he's already putting out his warning call. It's right over there. I'm somewhat concealed in this area, but not by much. Hiding out in bushes actually does conceal your presence quite a bit. Just giving out warning calls. I do find this game pretty relaxing, just like the Hunter Classic, which I have over 6 years of playing the Hunter. At first when it was just a single player game, and then it switched hands and became a multiplayer game. Though for the Hunter Classic, I kind of prefer the single player. Alright, so it is over this berm, and down into what I'm assuming is going to be farm fields, hopefully, on the other side. Alright, it's right over here. This thing's probably going to keep trotting. I'm always going to be behind. But the moment I start trying to sprint up on it, it's going to book it. So, I got to play this a bit more carefully. Ah, here comes the lighting. The lighting makes everything a little bit better. The sun has come up from behind the clouds and up over the horizon. Well, there goes it being a freaking farm field. Hunting these dang foxes in this high brush is just a pain in the bum. My visibility is pretty high. Trying to avoid pushing through all the brush here the best I can. I may have lost the bugger. Oh, nope. Alright, you can hear all the freaking leaves and branches swiping my clothes. Don't know why I freaking decided to use stuff made out of nylon or whatever the fuck it is. So loud at. Wait, is that it? No, that's just the lighting. Yeah. Oh, we got a deer up ahead. It is a doe, I believe. Yeah, we got two doe. What the fuck? Doe mating call is a burp. Figured went up this hill. Yep, up the hill, down the other side. Like I said, like, these foxes blazing fast. And then when you take one down and you see the bagging thing, they say it's a trivial creature to hunt. It's like, no, it's not. It's quite the opposite. Alright, here we go. We gotta be careful. Alright, we got doe on the right, which I might shoot if I don't see this fox in the field. Oh, there it is. Okay, and doe thinks it's fine. It was just a loud bang. What does it have to be concerned of? What? I shot you in the head! And that's... Okay, I'll see you later. I thought there was two. So AI, still a bit derp. Alright, let's bag this sucker. I'll take a picture first. Picture. Wait. It's highlighted blue. There we go. Alright. Flesh, upper neck, skull, jaw. I missed its brain somehow. It's a straight shot, that's for sure. Dang, man. Difficulty? 1. Trivial. Really? No. Trophy rating? 0. Was it because I... Oh. Well, shit. My harvest rating is only 40% on these guys. No, it's consecutive. Quick kill bonus is 100%. XP is poor. Cash is good. Alright, let's go catch up with this devil that seems to have a metal plate in the back of his dang head. It was booking it. Like, seriously, where's the blood? Like, I hit this thing in the back of the head. There we go. Blood trail, very low bleed. Really? I refuse to believe that thing can take a head shot. Keep on trucking. That is ludicrous. There it is. It is very ludicrous. So, it sometimes feel like they're starting off from straight up square one with, like, how things work when it comes to hunting. Because there is no way that deer should have ran off after taking that headshot. And I am sure it was a headshot. And the whole droppings thing always says just now. It could be like 10 years old and it'll say just now. Oh, shimmy Christmas! I bounced. Music is nice, if not a bit short, but it's just for transition purposes, so I kind of understand. You want to be more immersed in the environmental noises, which have proven itself to be quite good. And I think that's probably the one biggest improvement that I like about this game over the classic. The audio doesn't completely suck and be all reverse and broken and all that stuff. Okay, I think I lost it. Ah, crap. At least I don't have Doc yelling at me about it. But seriously, though, that doe should have went down. Should have been knocked out at the very least. There was no reason for it not to be knocked to freak out. If not just straight up dead, like it should have been. Now, if we're talking like the bison, then that would have made a little bit more sense. My little caliber bullet probably wouldn't get through the dang skull of that thing at that range. Alright, we're giving up on that doe. I guess live another day. Yes, yes, there's the whole issue of, well, you gotta bag what you shot, man. Can't let it suffer, blah, blah, blah. But that was a sure kill shot, and the game took it away from me. So nay. Nay, I say. Wait, what the frick is that out there? That's probably just a rock, but you never know. Oh, it's a sign. Alright, this is the perfect spot to actually give the example of how this game looks. Alright. So, get a really close-in stuff. You get a bit close, it looks good, but then you start to realize the textures might not all be there. But still pretty good. And then you get the really far away, and it's like, if it wasn't for the filters, it probably looked like complete crap. Then right... I don't know, right around... I'd say about around here, like, when you're around this area, it's like, alright, that's a pretty decent middle ground for the graphics. So, near? Pretty good. I mean, textures are a bit lacking here and there, but pretty good. Mid? It's like, it could be better. And then you start seeing far, and it's like, Like I said, the main strength of this game is actually probably the lighting, light and shadow, and the audio. And the animals actually look pretty good, too. But I kind of wish I could have high-res textures further out. I am pretty sure my computer can handle that much. Because it just, it doesn't look too good when you start focusing in on it. But, all culminates into a nice atmosphere in the end. And like, look, the tree isn't too bad when you get some lighting on that. It's actually pretty darn sweet. I mean, look at this. Isn't this nice? Yeah, there's certain spots, it's like, oh, it's not too bad. Until you look further out, and you're like, those trees look horrible. Under the canopy of the trees, I mean, moving through thick forest isn't too bad, though. But that's because you're up and close and personal and can't see anything far away. Wait. As you can see, I'm pushing down a bit of this grass, and you're like actually creating a bit of a trail. It's really impressive. I like the small details they did on that front. Alright, let me pull up the mission log and try this side mission here. Track mission. And where the frick is this mission? Alright, so if I remember correctly, she wanted some mating calls in this particular area. Hey, squirrel, I would shoot the squirrel, but they don't give me points for it. I've done it many a time. The rabbits I shoot doesn't give me a score either. I call shenanigans. And these little buggers will just pop out of the ground, just out of the blue. I had a rabbit just pop out of the ground next to me. It was, hella weird. Oh! Squirrels! Squirrels everywhere! Give me, like, a little freaking BB gun, a plinker, man, so I can start taking out some squirrels. That'd be fun. See, like, that audio is really nice. A bit odd here and there, though. Like, what we're hearing now with the wind, actually, it's supposed to be rustling of the leaves, primarily, but I'm so far away from the trees, it's a bit too loud on the leaf part. Like, right here, it would make sense I hear the rustling of the leaves that loud, because I'm right under the trees, but still. Like, potato, potato, like, it's still pretty good audio design. I'm gonna check out this farm. Might get some XP or something out of it. Alright, I know in the classic Hunter you can go up inside and get up into the windows and stuff of certain buildings. Structures, I should say. So, let's see if we can do that here. Nope. They're not letting me. I got some shooting holes I can shoot out from here, but quite visible. So that's a no-go, and I don't see any landmark things for me to hit up. There's a ladder I can't use. It'd be amazing if I can interact with this thing. Nope. I need to freaking turn on my V-Sync, and I got some screen tearing going on. Shoot. Alright, so we've been doing a lot of walking, and I have not heard one animal call. Which is odd. I'm not actually here for a nature hike, but that's what I'm getting. Oh, wait a minute. I'm just in disembodied hands, so no. Like, seriously, though. I can't see my arms, that's for sure. But I do have hands, and that is confirmed. This is a bummer. Where's all the animals? I'm not even coming across tracks. Like, I should at least come across some tracks. A little bit northwest here. See what happens. Plenty of boulders over here for the animals to glitch out on. Seriously. Where is everybody? Alright, so I'm downwind, so that's awesome. But still no animals. So, what's the point? Alright, hold on, let me take a look here. Got a feeling we're gonna have some animals up to our northwest. That being said, what was that mission? Escape calls between deer and the mating season is beginning. Okay. But what exactly do you want me to do? ID calls of two different fallow deer. Okay. Bad news, fallow deer gone extinct. I wiped them out. Thankfully, stalker lady hasn't said anything again about finding tracks, but in the same breath, I would like her to point out a track or two right about now, because there is nothing. Nothing going on. Like how this dang scope is zooming in my entire view. I'm sure that can't get glitched. Wait a minute. Oh, it's just a rock. Seems like a simple mission. ID 2 deer. Via audio. The moment I decide to do it, there's no animals around. So I'm left with the world's most boring walking simulator. Or at this point, jogging. But you get what I'm saying. This is bowing. Is that a rabbit or a squirrel? Wait a minute. Oh, that's probably the damn rabbit that ran out of the... Let's check this out. We got ourselves a little animal trail here. Well, I'm sure it's a rabbit or a damn squirrel. Oh, there he goes again. It's a rabbit! Got him! And even though you can hunt rabbits in the Hunter Classic, you cannot hunt them in here. You see that trail? That is amazing. Come on, I know I shot the bugger. The frick. Guess I didn't. Sure as heck disappeared though. She made Christmas. Freaking grass ninja. But yeah, this should have been early access. So almost makes me feel they may have accidentally hit the wrong button and hit the release button instead of the release early. Oh! What we got? We got, ooh, we got ourselves a boar. I wish there was a herd, but this will do. Wind direction, still downwind. All right, guys, we're getting ourselves a boar after 20 minutes of walking and enjoying the sights and sounds. We get to kill something. Alright. Up we go. And what the frick. Gotta watch out. These boar can be aggressive too. These boar be hella aggressive. Footprints of a roe deer. Do not care. I saw a boar. I'm gonna shoot a boar. All day, every day. Shut up, roe deer. Now, if you're followed here, I would be a lot more interested. Alright, well, that boar was moving north to south. I really want to catch its ass out in the freaking farm field. But I don't want to rush this. With my luck, it's probably already booked it out of here. I gotta be careful though, the wind's blowing north to south. The moment it gets south of me, it's gonna be a bad time. I have to parallel it and try to keep tracking it, which probably won't work out for me. Don't know why it's a solo boar. Only time I've seen a herd of boar so far, and I've only done maybe 6-7 hours of this game so far, but the only time I've seen a herd of boar, they were charging at me through the woods as I was being attacked by two bison. Oh, there we go. The bastard's getting away. two shots. Possibly a third, but let's be honest. I have no confidence I hit anything, but with the hitbox in this game, maybe. At least that roe deer properly reacted to me shooting. The last doe cared not for the death of that fox and assumed that it was none of its business until I put a bullet in the back of its head, at which point it shook it off and went on its way. So that was one OP doe. Alright, so we're moving over here, come on. Where the hell did I shoot this bugger? There's the blood. Alright, what we got? Hello, there we go. Bubble hit. Any more? When did I start shooting right here? Alright, so vital hit, bleed, second vital hit, bleed, oh, there we go. I'm about to find out if I got a proper shot on this bugger, but let's take a picture. This is my first boar kill, actually. For Call of the Wild, anyways. I've killed tons in the classic. It's kind of covered up. They need to fix that. Alright, two hits, so I did miss that third shot. It was flesh left lung, and then just a flesh wound on the second shot. Distance. Oh, hold on, where's my freaking mouse? Whatever. Alright, my mouse has disappeared in the cave. But yeah, 138 and then 143. That's pretty decent. Just a weapon score. Trophy types tusk. Difficulties 2 and a con and a minor. Oh, I made some bucks on that though. That's cool. And I'm missing my mouse, so I'll tab out and try to tab back in on this. Oh. Oh, I bagged it. Well, there's my mouse. And that's raining heavily. Alright, after a brief lull, by brief I mean like 20 minutes of nothing, you bagged yourselves a boar. This fallow deer is nowhere to be found in this area. I'll try more north, but I am not expecting any success at this point. Plenty of roe deer everywhere though. If I want some roe deer, I will get some roe deer. See? See? Alright, what have we learned? You can't shoot a roe deer in the head. Or any deer in the head. They don't care. That's a weird bug with that recoil. The scope derps super hard. Alright, I'm hunting the crap out of this area. Alright. Where'd you go? I found your poop. You say I scared the shit out of that roe deer. No, that's bad. Sorry. Sorry. Alright. Wait a friggin' second here. Getting bad trails. Where's my blood trail? the trot. We got one. Wait, mission complete. Alright. I do not question it. Hey rabbit, I shoot you, but you're not worth it. There's my blood. What we got? Better not be a flesh room. Tadnabbit. Flesh room. Alright, how about shot number two? These flesh rooms. Bleed rate very low. It's running. And it pooped. I don't know how that makes sense, but, you know, sometimes I gotta poop on the go. Poop out them bullets. So I can keep running. I actually just started trotting? What the frick? There's fallow deer in the area. That's cool. Alright. I heard you burp. And I can't. Okay, that was friggin' dumb. Oh, looks like we got a herd of deer up ahead. Load the muskets. Here I come. Oh, look what we got here, guys. Photo opportunity. Alright. There's no male deer in this group, that's for sure. That's kind of disappointing. Well, we got one in the backfield. I'll take that one. It's trotting. Seriously, why is there not a male leading this group? Alright, well. Gathering of the housewives, I guess. I'll be back for that deer. Trying to figure out what happened to Mr. Rowe. The Rowe. Like, you would think we'll take a break. No. I had a pretty good shot on that doe. It's about damn time you died, you bastard. Oh shit. Knocking over my coffee. Oh, well, that took forever. It's a flesh wound.
You sure that's a flesh wound?
I don't know about that. Just a flesh wound, guys.
Just a flesh wound.
Don't worry. It's only a flesh wound to the balls. Where's my friggin'. Oh, there we go. That is one hell of a flesh wound. Give me a sec, guys. Anything. This up before it becomes an issue. Okay. Oh man. Alright, that must be a bug. They called a nut shot a flesh wound. That's that would be incorrect. Alright, where's the blood? I know a shot. There we go. What do we got? Dag nab, man. These flesh wounds. Oh my gosh, man. Is that the same barn? Hold on. That was a different barn. Oh man. Sure was a pretty solid shot. Somewhere out here there is a deer calling. A little something something. That barn looks hella familiar. It's almost like they copied and pasted it. Ladder and all. Trying to find the one that had the blood trail. That was one hell of a herd, man. If I had a lever action, I probably should have closed the distance. If anything, I'm just not pinning at the at these instances. But that being said, that doe I shot in the head a while ago, I wasn't that far away. It was maybe 15-20 meters. And it gave zero shits. So they need to tweak the values on these bullets, because they ain't killing. I mean, I generally insta-kill these roe deer. I don't know how I nut-shotted that one roe deer. And I'm always left the question, is there a bullet drop? Because from what I've seen, there is no bullet drop. And from the trophy little screen, it has kind of shown me that with that straight-ass arrow that there's no bullet drop. Which there should be. If we're going to be having bullet values, then you need to go ahead and have proper physics here for these guns. Bullet physics. I guess it's a decent half step there, but come on. You're calling yourself a hunting sim for crying out loud. It's an interesting forest here. Nice and spacious. Spacious. Spacist. Alrighty. We shall find something to shoot in the face. Mark my words. It will happen. And when it does, it'll be glorious. Actually, I probably won't shoot in the face since headshots have proven to be a lot less effective right now, so. But if I'm close enough, I'll give another try, see what happens. What the? Fading call. Through the brush. I couldn't hear anything. Their audio cues are broken again. Well, they've been broken for a while, but. Wait. Just the brush playing tricks on me. Arma does it all the time. I think everybody's a soldier. The fuck? Some more of those giant red squirrels out here. Fallow deer, footprints. The sound indicator is a bit weird. It should drop just a little bit when I'm crouched, at least. Alright, so we got one female. Two female. What the fuck is this? Three female. all heading west. West to where? Oh no. Let's check the map. To a lake. Looks like they're now breaking south. Unfortunately, the winds have been blowing south for the longest of time, so we're just gonna hit the lake shore here and see what we can see before I wrap up this stream. I mean, I could go on, but I have other things to do. Wait a minute, what's this? Animal path. It kind of looks like one, but I don't think it is. Ooh, that's a nice little lake we got here. Mm-hmm. Alright. Let's go south. See what happens. What the frick is this? These guys are running a tight formation here. What in the world? Drinking zone. Okay, now it makes sense why they're out here. Oh, they're running. Shit. That's a male, too. I see no more Meldrax. What the frick is up with that noise? Just the one. He ninja'd his way on out of here. Oh no, there's some more tracks. Oh, contact. 12 o'clock. Days. But where's the male? There you are. Two. Alright, which one looks boss? Very easy. I think this one on the right has a better set of antlers. So that's what I'm gonna go with. Stalk the herd. That was a shot to the neck, so I might prove ineffective for one reason or another, because, you know, deer can handle it just fine having a hole in the damn neck. He shouldn't be able to get too far, but we shall see. I saw another buck in there. I'll track that down too, if possible. They're grazing the water around here. Let's see here. Is that, it's probably gonna be a flesh wound. Nope. Flesh wound. Oh my gosh. That's getting ridiculous. I think they did an update recently, but they just, if they did, like, I feel like this gun was a lot more effective before. Now it's freaking useless. And it's your starting gun, which you need that makes your monies do shit. And they made it kind of useless. But this may not be a new change, but it seems like it is. Alright, this is walk, so that's when it was cool. No. Not the track. Dagnabbit, see, we lost it. I need to be looking at all these tracks to activate the tracks for crying out loud. It's not rocket science. Just fucking common sense. Alright, I think I'm moving up ahead. Oh, we got one. And I think that's the injured one right there. Hella far out. That's the second shot. It better have been worth something. It better have been worth something. I better not hit the second one, or this is going to be even more of a pain in the ass. Oh, this might be a problem. How far away was this bugger? Alright, what do we got? We got two blood spots, so it must have been the same one. Bleed late, rate low. Just now, just a flesh wound. Oh my gosh. And so we continue on our trek. Alright, well, this boy is not leaving too many tracks. That's for sure. Some rain, that's nice. I guess. Seriously though, where's the blood trail? This bugger just took two bullets. .243, man. Huh. The frick is that? A fox? Oh, it's a bison. Sure, I'll accept whatever the frick that is, but I'm busy currently. Alright. So, let's head back to our last spot. I know I saw the thing run up this dang hill. Oh shit! Scared the crap out of me. Who are you? Why are you charging at me? That's freaking weird. Alright. Oh, hells, wait a minute. I hit two different deer. Both flesh wounds, of course. Confusing tracks. Wow, that's... You hear that? I think it's alternating between the shoreline water and the rain, and it's not working out. No! And there goes my audio again, because it wants to track something I'm not even looking at. Double check this. Turn around, and then it went down here. Yep. What the heck is going on with this dang deer? I think it turned around again and realized it's still tracking. Wait, what the frick? How did I end up on yours? What did I hit? I hit a female? Well, crap. I did not pay attention to my tracks. But again, flesh wound. I wouldn't be surprised if that female that I shot a ways back. What the frick? Subsurface depression. Neat. Well, looks like we're just going to be tracking this. I lost the male anyways. Another drinking zone has been discovered. Dagnab, I'm just losing these things. But it's not my fault. Suddenly these bullets are useless. This is the high penetration stuff. I should be damaging some lungs and some hearts, some livers. Something. Got a little island over there. And I lost tracks. Well, this is quite unsuccessful. What the frick is that? That's a rock. Bit of a sinkhole going on here. Alright, I need to get off this coastline, cut inland. But I'm about to give this a break because me bullets aren't killing. Yeah, I'm killing at all. All these flesh wound hits, man. It's ridiculous. Alright, come on. Oh, come on. Having trouble getting over nothing, it seems. It's not that steep of a hill. Alright. Any luck, I'll come across a corpse. I might come across a corpse, but I doubt it. These buggers can go for miles and miles with two bullets in them sometimes. I'm no hunter, but that's some nice mud right there. Look at that mud. Too bad I don't have feet. Let's take a look at my, okay, kind of wrapping back into where I was before. We're breaking direct south, well not direct south, southeast. See if I can come across these blasted tracks. Though I'm down it at this point. Female deer, the doe went along the coastline and probably broke into the woods, but it's hard telling. And then we got, what's this here? We got some deer trotting. Trying to find that dang buck I freaking shot. Man, I'd be afraid to use freaking bows. I wonder if they give you more points though. There's the blood. Back on the trail. Kind of, sort of. Very low blood loss. For whatever reason. Why are you running? Why are you running? I just want to bag this bugger. There you are, you bastard. Finally bled to death. Let's see where the game thinks I friggin' shot him. Firm trophy, hold on, let's take a picture. A really bad picture because friggin' all these leaves are getting in the friggin' way. Scapula. Really? Let's take a look at this. Zoom. I can zoom. Okay. Really? I can believe that. But for it to freaking blitz it that fast and that far, I guess in my eye. It's called very easy. Okay. Hey, try out hard. Man, if they had some wolves, I'd probably get murdered by them easy. I'd probably have to roll out with freaking buckshot and a semi-automatic shotgun. Ah, my. Okay. Well, at least we bagged that bugger. Got 17,000 cash. I'm finally level 5, so I can buy the antler rattler thingamabob. I have a mission back the way I came. I should probably check out. Man, this trek had me go all the way across. You can see where I'm like this is where I hunted. Like, that is it. But if you hit up the towers here, you can highlight more of the area, which I have not been doing. Probably should. But let me go ahead and fast travel back here. I'm not gonna place a waypoint. Which waypoint placement is broken still? Fast travel. There we go. But there's no point in placing waypoints. Point in placing waypoints because it doesn't show on your UI or on your hunter mate, the little phone you walk around with. So it's kind of broke. Like I said, this is more beta than anything, but it still has its highlights. But that is going to be it for this bit of live stream gameplay commentary for the Hunter Call of the Wild. It will be posted on YouTube, so if you're watching on YouTube, please thumbs up the video, leave some comments, suggestions, tell me that I suck at hunting. I don't really care. If you're watching live on the Twitch, though, please follow. And stay tuned for more gameplay commentary, be it the Hunter or maybe Star Citizen, but let's be honest. But yeah, it's been fun. I'll catch you all later.